economics in the informal or shadow economy, we're looking at how do businesses actually embrace human enhancement. You know, how do you as a company write policies for something like brain uploading when it's not going to happen for 10 to 15 years? But how do you start to think about what your policy will be? We're looking at how technology could disrupt the legal system, and we're just finishing a project for the European Union looking at the science and technology that could shape the next 40 years. So that's sort of where I'm coming from. And one of the things that we see very clearly right now is that we're kind of reaching the beginning of the end for a lot of organisations. The conversations we have with government leaders, CEOs, people in every sector, is that they're beginning to understand that the old ways of doing things, trying to respond to the kind of stuff you're going to hear about for the next 2 days, trying to respond to that using the old rules of the game, the old ways of assuming we did things, the old someone must win, someone must lose type model, the old kind of views about how you distribute resources in society, the old views about how you make decisions. We're realizing that we're coming to the end of that. And we can't change and accommodate the sort of things that are coming by just changing what we're doing. We actually have to change what we're being. We have to start changing the nature of the game itself. And some of the things that are shaping that are not things that are in the distant horizon. They're actually happening right now. So we know that, for example, the global economy, all our governance systems are creaking. Today, the rich economies of the world have a debt of more than 100% of GDP. We know that the last financial crisis was triggered by subprime mortgages, which are an example of derivatives contracts. Today, the estimated value of derivatives is somewhere between $700 and $800 trillion. Now, that's a big margin of error, but the thing is, most derivatives aren't traded on any exchange, so we don't know. To put that in context, that's more than 10 times the size of the global economy, which is why when global leaders get together at the G20 meetings, they really don't know how to deal with this. We're in uncharted territory, and about the only decision that most of them can make is whether to have prawns or chicken for lunch. You know, we're not making real decisions about how to navigate the future.